Horrified woman finds her dog covered in odd marks. Sees vet and understands the worst has happened. A woman found her dog covered in odd marks and brought him to the vet, where she discovered something horrifying under his skin. When it comes to our pets, we want to keep them fit and healthy. But just like any animal, they're bound to get a few bites or scratches. So when one woman saw some marks on her dog, she thought nothing more of it, until she realized they weren't bug bites. Humans and animals have been inseparable for thousands of years. Humans domesticated cats and dogs in the Stone Age for companionship and partnership. Yet, for every perfect pairing of person and pet, there are many people in the world who should never be allowed to own a pet or be anywhere near animals, as they aren't able to properly look after them. A good pet owner hopes that their companion is always healthy and happy. While it's inevitable that animals will probably get few injuries, bites, and scratches from time to time, a pet owner sees to it that it can be avoided as much as possible. Hayden Howard is a 36-year-old wife and mother from Seymour, Indiana. Aside from these noble professions, she's also a certified dog lover. Since she got married and started to build her own family, Hayden always imagined having a sweet-natured animal as one of her family members. Her husband helped her find the perfect dog. They checked various adoption centers in and outside their community. After some time, Hayden found what she was looking for. It was an English Mastiff puppy. When Hayden gave birth to her son Noah, she felt that it was the perfect time to adopt a puppy. When they saw the adorable English Mastiff, Hayden knew she wanted it to grow side by side with her son. She decided to call the new member of the family Jackson. Hayden and the whole family took great care of Jackson. The days passed by swiftly, and the puppy grew up as a happy and loving pet. Young Noah also found himself a new best friend. Since Hayden and her husband both have full-time jobs, Noah was often left alone with a nanny. Hayden was confident that her young son always had company, as Jackson's favorite human was her son. The English Mastiff had grown so big over the months, and it seemed that he could always protect the little boy. Every day, Noah played with Jackson. The Mastiff's massive size didn't become a problem for the little boy to walk him out for an exercise. Hayden and her husband were happy that their family was such a simple and happy one. Until one day. No matter how long the day had been, Hayden would always find time to bond with her son as well as with their dog. Jackson used to sit with them at night while they watched movies just like any human would. Then one evening, however, Hayden noticed that something was quite different. The usually active Mastiff lay almost motionless on the floor. Her little boy Noah was beside Jackson, as if his young mind was trying to figure out what was wrong. Hayden initially thought that Jackson fell ill, but when she got closer, she saw the odd marks on the dog's body. At first, Hayden thought that Jackson had bug bites. She was aware that dogs are prone to common parasites, especially if they usually play outdoors. She remembered that Jackson had stayed in their fenced-in backyard for a long time over the weekend. Hayden's mind was wandering about the common treatments for bug bites. She knew that it could also affect her son because he had a habit of hugging their adorable English Mastiff. But upon closer inspection, Hayden realized that she would need more than just home remedy. Hayden remembered being extremely shocked when she realized Jackson was actually covered in bullet holes. In an instant, she was caught in between emotions: anger for whoever was responsible and pity for her helpless dog. Without wasting any seconds, Hayden called her husband and told him that Jackson needed immediate medical attention. While the dog was trying to act like nothing was wrong, Hayden could only imagine the pain their dog was feeling. Who in their right mind would shoot at a helpless dog? Jackson had his fair share of trips to the local veterinarian. However, he only went there a few times for illness because Hayden's family gave him all the care and love possible in the world. It's one of the reasons why Hayden was feeling so angry. Hayden was aware of animal cruelty, and she was sickened how people could be so cruel to animals. She couldn't believe that someone from their neighborhood would be so heartless. When the vet finally confirmed what happened to the poor dog, Hayden was appalled. The veterinarian was shocked at Jackson's condition. He attended to the poor dog right away and found several small pellets. Hayden was informed that the bullets appeared to have been fired from a BB gun. Hayden had seen that her dog had so many wounds. However, the vet found even more. In fact, poor Jackson had so many wounds that the doctor had to shave off almost all of his fur to find all of the plastic shells. It was all too much for her. Hayden wanted to be with her dog inside the clinic. However, the more she watched his ordeal, the heavier her heart got. She said that she could no longer bear to watch the procedure, so she returned to the waiting room while the veterinarian continued working. Outside, Hayden and her family discussed what happened. Noah kept on asking questions about Jackson. All of them didn't want the incident to just pass and decided to report what happened to the authorities. Finally, the vet came out of the clinic. Hayden was notified that her dog would make it. However, she needed intense care and attention. Despite the good news, Hayden was left shaken by what she'd learned from the doctor. According to the vet, he had removed 20 bullets and 7 plastic pellets from the puppy's body. There was even a bullet stuck under his eyelid, one in his ear, and one lodged in his knee. There were 20 more bullet holes in Jackson's body, but the vet was unable to recover those shots. Hayden was handed a small cup full of bullets and pellets. She was horrified. She couldn't imagine the pain Jackson had felt while the culprit was sadistically enjoying his suffering. She felt a strong urge to find out who's responsible for the heartless attack. After coming home from the veterinarian's clinic, Hayden and her husband went straight to the police. They took the bullets with them. The police officers were also horrified by the report. Immediately, they prepared to carry out an investigation. All of them were determined to identify and capture the mysterious culprit. The police officers went in and examined the Howards' residence. They also visited the backyard where Jackson and Noah used to play. Using their skills and instinct acquired from training, they came up with a conclusion in just a few hours. According to the police, the young dog had been shot more than 7 times. The assistant chief of the Seymour Police Department, Craig Hayes, said he'd never seen a small animal shot so many times and was saddened by the case. For everyone who heard about what happened to Jackson, there was only one question that topped everything. How could someone do something so terrible to a dog, especially a puppy? Hayden had a suspicion, but she didn't need to tell it to the police as they'd already reached the same conclusion. Only a human under the influence could do such a cruel thing to a helpless dog. Hayden remembered that Jackson usually played in the backyard with her little Noah. She shuddered at the horrible thought that crossed her mind. Seymour police officers investigating Hayden Howard's home said they found evidence to suggest which direction the bullets and pellets were fired from. They also found several bullets lodged in a tree on the property by following the angle and direction of the fire. They were able to determine that these shots came from a nearby yard on Vessel Edge Road. So the police began to canvass the neighborhood. They were hot on the suspect's trail and soon obtained a warrant to search the house next door. According to Seymour Police Detective Sergeant C.J. Foster, they found several bullets and a gun that was hidden in the neighbor's home. Upon carrying out further search, the police officers also found drug paraphernalia and methamphetamine in the house. One man in the house next door was arrested on drug possession charges. The police, of course, carried out their investigation and asked the man about the shooting that happened to the dog. However, according to Foster, the suspect refused to answer without an attorney. Although they got a lead, the police officers were still following the evidence in the investigation. The officers in Seymour hoped to send some evidence to the Indiana State Police Lab for further examination and testing, which would allow them to confirm their suspicions. Hayden Howard was distressed and confused, saying she just didn't know what to think about the attack on her dog. She said that the neighbor in question had always been kind to Jackson and that their daughter walked him. She couldn't understand why they would hurt the puppy. A reward was offered for more information on the case, and the authorities hope that they'll soon be able to bring the case to a satisfactory close. Despite the big trauma, Jackson remains in good spirits and is returning to health. According to Hayden, Jackson was responding great to his medication. He's well at home, taking medicine and everything while the case is being investigated. Hayden promised to herself that she wouldn't stop until justice had been served to her beloved dog. Thankfully, Jackson continues to live a healthy and happy life today. But there are some animals out there who don't get the chance. it's important to always keep an eye out for any markings on your pet. Although they looked like bug bites, they were something far more sinister and harmful that inflicted unimaginable damage to Jackson. It's important to remember that animals are living beings and feel pain to the same degree that humans do.